Hey, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to quickly create the look of painted text or graphic on an asphalt road. For your convenience, I provided this image of an asphalt road that you could use for this project. Its link is in my video's description or project files. Before we begin, if you want to know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials, smash that subscribe button, and please remember to click like if you like this video. For this example, we'll use text on the road. Open your horizontal type tool. We want our text to be white, so let's check our foreground and background colors. If they're not black and white, press D on the keyboard. We need to make white our foreground color, so we'll invert the colors by pressing X on our keyboard or by clicking this icon. Open your type picker. Pick any font you like. For my text, I'll make it size 262 points, but feel free to adjust the size based on the font you choose and the number of characters in your text. The aliasing is smooth and center alignment. Click on your document and type out your text. To adjust the space between our lines of text, we'll drag our cursor over the text to highlight it and click the character icon or go to Window and Character. Place your cursor over the leading icon. It changes to a scrubby slider icon. Click and drag it to the left or right. To adjust the character spacing of our entire text, place your cursor over the tracking icon and drag the scrubby slider to the right or left. To adjust the space between two characters, place your cursor between those characters and press and hold Alt or Option and the left or right arrow key on your keyboard. We can close the character panel now. We'll convert our text into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. Open your Move tool and click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel. Click Convert to Smart Object. Next, we'll make our text conform to the perspective of the road. We can either use the Vanishing Point feature or the Transform tool. In this case, we'll use the Transform tool since it'll be quicker and easier. Press Ctrl or Command T to open it. First, we'll elongate our text vertically, since all painted text on roads look like this because they're easier to read from our vantage point in the vehicle. To elongate our text, go to the top or bottom middle anchor point and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as we drag it up or down respectively. Then press Enter or Return or click the check mark at the top. Go to Edit, Transform, and Distort. Go to each corner and press and hold the Shift key as you drag it out to just inside the white painted markings. Pressing Shift keeps our text horizontal. Essentially, we want the bounding box of the Transform tool to be aligned with the perspective of the white markings. To make more room on our canvas, press Ctrl or Command and the minus key on our keyboard. Once we're happy with its perspective, press Enter or Return. To zoom back in, press Ctrl or Command and the plus key on the keyboard. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 3 pixels. Make the background active and make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Drag it to the top of the Layers panel. Ctrl or Command click the thumbnail of our text layer to select its shape. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. Make the top layer active and change its blend mode to hard light. Make a copy of it and change the blend mode of the copy to soft light. Double-click an empty area of the layer under it to open its layer style window. We'll blend this layer more into the road by using the Blend If feature. Essentially, Blend If uses the luminosity of layers to blend them together. This layer represents our active layer, and the underlying layer represents all the layers under our active layer. Moving the top black and white sliders will cause areas of our active layer to disappear from view. Moving the bottom sliders will cause areas of the layers below our active layer to show through the active layer, as if punching holes through it. We can smooth out the blending by splitting the sliders in two. To do this, place your cursor in the middle of the triangle and press Alt or Option as we click it. This splits it in two. We can now drag both halves independently of each other until we're happy with the results. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.